Now, George Carlin.
Hi, thank you. How are you doing? Hello. Welcome. Hi. Thank you. Thank you. Welcome to Fridays. They call the show Fridays, but you know what they do? They rehearse it on Thursday. Doesn't seem right to me. How can you possibly get Friday straightened out on Thursday? I have trouble getting Thursday straightened out on Thursday, you know? Sometimes I'm still working on Wednesday. But today is Friday, or Friday. Friday, Friday. Which one? Do you say Friday or Friday? I don't say either one of them. I just don't bother with it at all, you know? I'm feeling pretty good, though, I want to tell you. Lately, things have been going well in my life. Give you a little example. Just this morning, I found some macaroni and cheese that I lost about a year and a half ago. I had given up on it, you know. I had written it off. I figured, hey, it's gone, man. The macaroni and cheese is gone. You got to do that. When you lose something like that, you have to... Like, let's say you lose a bowl of noodles. Okay, you lose a bowl of noodles. First thing you say to yourself is, oh, wow, where could I have left the noodles, man? You got to think back where you were. You got to retrace your steps during the day, try to figure out where you might have left the noodles. You got to call people up. Did anybody turn in any noodles? No, we had some rice-a-roni this morning, and somebody turned in a double portion of tuna-flavored top ramen, but nothing on the noodles. And you just got to give it up then. Just got to cut them loose, man. Cut the noodles loose. You got to do grief work on the noodles, you know? Separation anxiety. Get rid of them. That's what my grandfather used to say. He'd say, son, you can always buy more noodles. Unfortunately for us, he said it over and over and over. So I figured I had the macaroni and cheese out of my mind, and then this morning I'm looking through some shoes that I hardly ever wear, and here's the macaroni and cheese, man. What I had done was I took the macaroni and cheese with me to the shoe store. I wore the new shoes home. I put the macaroni and cheese in the bag with the old shoes. Threw it in the closet and forgot about it. So I'm feeling a little bit better. I don't like losing things. I never liked losing things. As a child, it was no fun to have lost something. Parents are no help when you lose something.
Ma! Hey, Ma! I lost my yo-yo!
Where did you have it last?
If I knew that, Ma, I would know where the yo-yo is.
Well, I just didn't get up and walk away. Don't you love that? One time I lost the dog. My mother said, well, he just didn't get up and walk away. That just might be it, Ma. And let me ask you this. When something is lost, where does it go? Do you think that everything that's lost is in one place, maybe? At least for a little while, that it all goes away to one big pile. And then when you find it, it comes back again. It's got to be somewhere. It's not here. It's not where I left it. I've looked everywhere. It's lost. Forever. That's the first thing they do when you get to heaven, you know. They give you back all the things you ever lost. That's right. All those ballpoint pens and cigarette lighters, earrings, cufflinks. Even that underwear that somehow you managed to lose on the freeway. They give it back to you. All those wallets you lost, they give you every wallet you lost. They give you the cards and the pictures. They do keep the money, though. Why should it be any different in heaven? When you lose something at home, like, do you look everywhere? But I mean, like, even moronic places. Like, if you lose your watch, do you look in the oven? Might be in there. Or if you come home and, like, your TV set is missing, the only thing that's missing, you come home, where could it be? Was here this morning, the only thing gone, no TV set. And you look around, you go into different rooms, as if you had moved it and forgotten about it. And finally, do you look in the shower? I think you have to look in the shower. Before you can report a stolen TV set to the police, you better look in the shower. Because suppose the guy says, did you look in the shower? And it's there, you feel really stupid, you know? Sometimes it's not an object that's lost, it's you. I'm lost.
Honey, we're lost.
No, we're not, we're right here. Being lost when you're a kid is really scary.
Mama, huh? I'm lost, lost, lost. Mama, mama, mama.
Scary. I lost my place. Before I lose my composure, before you lose respect, and the people at home lose interest, and the man in the control room loses his patience, and somebody at ABC loses his job, I'm getting lost. See?
Next on the Friday edition, chain smoker coughs up Pittsburgh.